Today we will be looking at Railway Mania. What can we learn from it and can we use it in cryptocurrencies of today? So stay tuned to find out.
Crypto Media Service, bringing you in-depth thoughts on cryptocurrencies.
Welcome to Crypto Media Service. I'm your host, the Golden Boy, and I will be taking an alternative look at cryptocurrencies, this time comparing it to Railway Mania, see what we can learn from Railway Mania in the modern cryptocurrency market, because there's a lot of economical factors which we can learn from. So stay tuned to learn a little bit about what the railroad bubble was and what we can learn from it. So let's start by looking back at the 1840s, where we saw the Industrial Revolution really get going, where we saw factories, new production methods, new mining methods, and a higher need for coal at factories, a higher need for transportation of wares from point A to point B, and bigger cities beginning to demanding more goods. All of this in concoction with each other led to a need for a better and more highly efficient transportation system. So to get a high efficient system and a cost beneficial system, a lot of investors thought to look at trains, because in the 1840s the UK have already had trains for over 70 years, which meant a lot of development. There were already over 300 miles of tracks laid there. So by mid-1840s, we saw a lot of investors getting into railroad development and railroad establishment. And this was in fact because of a boom in the UK economy. This boom, well, it gave us a lot of factories, no ways of transporting them. There were a gap. This gap a lot of investors gotten into and invested a lot of money in developing new railroads. And laws at the time were not as complicated as they are today. So everyone could submit a bill to the parliament to form a new railroad company. There were no demands on the financial viability of the company. Therefore, a lot of small, unviable companies were created. These companies were largely created so that, well, the investor could get in on some of the stock market action, where railroad stock just continued to go up and up and up. Even railroad stocks without proper fundamental railways established just continued to go up and up and up. Railroad stock peaked in 1846 and began its march toward the bottom right after that. It was a quick march to the bottom. In the time that the bubble had occurred, Britain saw a lot of development in railroad. It is what has laid the foundation for all of the railroads today in Britain. And I do say the foundation because, of course, they have continued developing on railroads until today. But what can we take from railroad mania into cryptocurrencies? We can take the viability issue, because as the price did rise in railroad mania, a lot of new companies which were unviable did rise and were sold for a lot of money. And I believe if we see more bubbles in cryptocurrencies, we will see new coins being formed, people trying to get in on all sorts of coins. But we have to look at the viability. Is the coin viable after a bubble? Does it have the foundation to continue developing after a potential bubble bursting? This might be hard to spot, but do your due diligent research and you will be able to spot them. I have taken the lessons from Railroad Mania and applied them to cryptocurrency. So before I invest in any coin, I always look at the viability after a potential bubble burst. I look at how legit the coin is, and that's the same which you should have done if you had lived in the 1840s and invested in railroads, because such a company as Great Western Rails, which had been around since 1835, so well before the beginning of the bubble. This company does still exist today, so that would have been a viable investment opportunity because they had established their foundation back before the bubble began. And with that, you can transfer it into cryptocurrency, such a coin as Etherium, Bitcoin. Oh, we don't want to forget Bitcoin. Those two coins have laid a big foundation before you saw mass adoption, or at least mass investment. I would not say adoption because that was the wrong word, but mass investment. And when you see mass investment, all of these new coins popping up under a mass investment, you have to look, are they viable? How are they founded? What is the backing of the coin? Who backs the coin? And all sorts of factors. Because even though it is formed under a bubble, it might actually be viable. So I hope you have learned something about bubbles and taking my words into consideration. So thank you for watching. Remember to click like if you liked this video, dislike if you disliked it, click subscribe and that little bell notification icon so you get notified every time we upload a new video. In the description, I have given some links to some relevant articles. So until next time, have a great week. Bye bye.